Hello students, this is a special video specially made for the syllabus of 2022 on metallurgy. There was a huge lot of portions in metallurgy, but for you, for this year, it's been cut down. And so I thought, let me just teach you only what is required for this exam. Here we go. We have to know three terms in this metallurgy. The first one being minerals. Okay, minerals are, what are the minerals? See, for example, you can have, if you take sodium, it can be in a combined state in so many ways, isn't it? Say, for example, sodium carbonate, it is in the combined state. Sodium sulfate, okay, sodium chloride, sodium sulfide, and so on. You can have innumerable ways of combining sodium because sodium is a very highly reactive metal. Okay, now all these things are in the impure state and naturally occurring. These are called minerals. So here they are compounds of various metals. So not only this, see, when they are present along with sodium, potassium chloride may be present, or magnesium nitrate may be present. So it's a combination of compounds of various metals found in nature, but don't forget, it also has some impurities. That is called a mineral. Okay, now among all these different types of sodium compounds, there can be one thing that is actually very, very cheap, easily available, and the method of extracting the metal also is profitable. It gives you a lot of profit. That is called as the ore. Again, it's a naturally occurring mineral. See, remember, all these are naturally occurring minerals. But from this, what are we doing? We are taking just one form of this, that is the ore, from which it can be extracted two ways, profitably as well as easily. It should be cheap and easily available. So that is called an ore. Then the third term that we need to know is gang or impurities. Okay, gang means what? Impurities. During the extraction of a metal, the impurities that are found, they are found in the earth's crust. So what would you have? You would have rocky impurities, you would have other minerals, other ores. Okay, so those form the impurities, and that is called as gang. So these are the three terms that we need to know. Then coming to the extraction of metals, before that, we need to learn the ores of aluminium, zinc and iron. Okay, all we need to know is just the name, the common name and the formula. So these are the three things that we need to know about it. Now when you come to the ores of aluminium, the most abundant one available ore of aluminium is bauxite. And what is bauxite? It is hydrated aluminium oxide. Hydrated means it contains water. Two molecules of water with aluminium oxide is what is called as bauxite. Then you have cryolite. Cryolite is another ore of aluminium. That is Na3AlF6. What does it have? Sodium aluminium fluoride. So that's another ore of aluminium. Then corundum. Corundum is aluminium oxide. Actually, this is the source from which you get the rubies and sapphires. Okay, so that is corundum. Then coming to the ores of zinc, you have zinc blend. Okay, that is zinc sulfide. Then you have calumen, that is zinc carbonate. That looks something like this. Okay. Next you have zincite, that is zinc oxide. When you come to the ores of iron, you have hematite Fe2O3, iron 3 oxide. That looks something like this. This is hematite. Okay. The next ore of iron is magnetite. That is a higher oxide of iron, Fe3O4, triferic tetroxide. And that looks something like this. The color is black and it is dull in color. And then you have iron pyrites, from which you can prepare sulfuric acid, manufacture sulfuric acid, spathic iron ore, that is iron to carbonate. So these are the different ores of aluminium, zinc and iron. Now coming back to the extraction. Usually extraction of metals, you have four stages, okay? Step by step, you extract, you remove the impurities. So coming to the stage one, see, when you want to get ready for a wedding or you want to go for a party, the first thing you would do is to dress up. You would not just go as you come back from school, you're not going to go anywhere, right? So here also, the first stage is to getting dressed up, or dressing, or you're getting the ore ready. That is called as concentration of the ore, okay? And in the case of aluminium, because that's the only thing we have in the syllabus this year, it is called also called as Bayer's process, and it is made of three steps, okay? It's not one step, but three steps. Now, the ore that we have selected for this is what? The most abundant ore, and that is bauxite. Okay, so we take this bauxite ore in the first step. See, you can see this diagram. It's made of three steps basically. Leave this clarification or settling down, the digestion, precipitation, and then calcination. So these are the three basic steps that are involved in the Bayer's process. Coming to the first step, what happens here? What is the principle behind this method in the Bayer's process is the amphoteric nature of aluminium. This method is based on the amphoteric nature of aluminium. Why is it based on that? See, what is amphoteric metal? It is something that can react with both acid as well as base to give you salt and water. What's an amphibian? Something that lives in both land and water. Ampho, both. Okay, so amphoteric means it can react with acid as well as base. There are other impurities present in this bauxite. Along with bauxite, you have iron 2 oxide, you have titanium oxide, okay, you have silica, SiO2. These are impurities. This is a basic impurity. It will not react with another base. But aluminium being amphoteric, it would react with the base. So we take that as the principle behind this Bayer's process. Okay. Now coming to the steps here, we take bauxite, that is Al2O3.2H2O. This is the formula of bauxite. What are we going to do? We are going to digest it with concentrated hot alkali, that is sodium hydroxide. When these two react in the digester at a temperature of 150 to 200 degrees Celsius, they would react to form sodium aluminate. Okay, why do you get that? Because the sodium hydroxide here dissolves the oxides of aluminium, leaving all others as undissolved. So they will be left behind. This only forms the red mud, okay? Iron 3 oxide, that is Fe2O3, and silica, these together form the red mud. Some of the bauxite ores from different places have different concentrations of these, okay? But in general, both of them give that redness, and the residue is called as the red mud. So that is removed in the first step. So you get sodium aluminate and water. Now let us see how to balance this. There are two aluminium atoms. So let us write 2 here, in which case sodium also becomes 2. So 2NaOH. Now we need to balance the number of hydrogen atoms. Here you have 2 into 2, 4 hydrogen atoms plus another 2 you have on the whole, you have 6. Therefore, we multiply this by 3. Now it is balanced. Okay, this is called as sodium aluminate. This dissolves, but others are undissolved and it is left back as the red mud. So what is the function of the sodium hydroxide in this step? It dissolves the oxides of aluminium to form sodium aluminate. That is the function of sodium hydroxide here. The second step is precipitation. That's what we see here. And here what we do is, it is also, we can be called as hydrolysis. So we are using water here
at a temperature of 50 to 60 degrees. Okay, now you get back sodium hydroxide and aluminium hydroxide is formed here. So by the end of this reaction, you get a precipitate of aluminium hydroxide. That is why this step is called as precipitation. Okay, for any reaction to happen, you need a trigger, isn't it? See, you can see in the class itself, if somebody starts laughing, the whole class starts laughing. So that is the trigger, right? Like that here, the trigger for this reaction is you introduce one or two crystals of aluminium hydroxide. That process is called as seeding. Okay, so aluminium crystals, one or two, a few crystals are introduced into this mixture. That triggers the formation of so many aluminium hydroxide, and those precipitate will settle down, then it is filtered, dried, and then goes to the last step, that is calcination. Here what happens, this aluminium hydroxide is ignited, okay, at a very high temperature of 1100 degrees. Okay, at 1100 degrees when it is ignited, you get alumina, which is pure, and water. Water is removed from that. Now, there are two aluminium atoms, so we write 2 here. And water becomes 3 into 2, 6. Therefore, if you put 3 here, then 3 plus 3, 6 oxygen atoms, or 3 into 2, 6 here. So, this is balanced. This is a balanced equation. Okay, so this is how by the end of the third step, you get pure alumina. This is the end of stage 1. Okay, this is made of 3 steps. The first step is the digester. Then the second step is precipitation, where you also learn about seeding. And the third step is it is ignited to give you pure alumina. Now it is ready to go into the stage 2, which is not required because stage 2 is something to do with conversion of all other forms into the oxide forms. Here we already have the oxide form, so we don't need stage 2. Stage 3 we would see in the next video. So don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Bye-bye.